Attackers could listen to audio conversations. A Lenovo bug affects over 100 laptop models, and zero days and disclosures are on the rise. All that coming up now on ThreatWire. Greetings, I am Shannon Morse, and this is ThreatWire for April 26, 2022. This is your summary of the threats to our security, privacy, and internet freedom. Let's go ahead and learn about audio codecs. Does your Android device run on a Qualcomm or a MediaTek chipset? It most likely does, as these are a couple of the biggest chip makers for smartphones around the world. This May, researchers will share new findings at CanSec West, showing how these chipsets are vulnerable to remote code execution attacks, all because of a flaw in ALAC, which is A-L-A-C, which is the Apple lossless audio codec, which is supported on Android phones since it was open source back in 2011 by Apple. Security fixes are released from time to time for open source audio codecs, but that does not mean that third-party vendors will apply those patches to devices that support them. And Apple has not supplied any updates to their open source code, which is available on GitHub. And according to Checkpoint Research, this means about two-thirds of Android users could be affected by an easy-to-exploit flaw that they had discovered. Checkpoint Research explains that an attacker could use this hack, which is dubbed AL hack, to get access to media and audio conversations. Researchers discovered that this could also allow an attacker to execute malicious code, execute malware, escalate privileges, and stream data from a compromised device camera, alongside snooping on conversations. While technical details are sparse until CanSec West, we do know that these issues cause out-of-bounds reads and writes, validation issues with audio frames, information disclosure, and those elevations of privileges. The researchers also mentioned these vulnerabilities could be exploited if an attacker sent a media file, like a song, to a victim. When it's played, code injection could occur. Checkpoint Research disclosed their findings to Qualcomm and MediaTek, and both vendors assigned CVEs, and they did patch those issues. You can find the CVEs as CVE 2021-0674, 0675, and 30351. And since all of those are patched, updating your devices to at least the December 2021 security patch is advised, and don't play media files from unknown sources. Apple has updated their proprietary codec, but not the open source one. Qualcomm and MediaTek have been using these open source codecs. So this begs the question, are there other open source codecs with undiscovered vulnerabilities too? It's entirely plausible given these findings. Lenovo has their Unified Extensible Firmware Interface, aka UEFI, available on 100 plus laptop models, and these are vulnerable to three problems, which were discovered by ESET researchers and responsibly disclosed to Lenovo back in October of 2021. Now, these issues were patched in security updates. This could potentially affect millions of Lenovo customers, since their list of affected devices includes popular models such as IdeaPads, Legion laptops, Yogas, and a lot more. The first two flaws stem from a couple of firmware drivers called Secure Backdoor and Secure Backdoor PEAM, which are used during manufacturing, and they were introduced into those production models. CVE 2021-3971 is caused by a driver that is used in older manufacturing processes, making its way into those consumer Lenovo notebook devices. Now, this was mistakenly included in the BIOS image, and it could allow for privilege escalation and the ability for an attacker to modify firmware protection. The second flaw is CVE 2021-3972, which also is a manufacturing driver that should just not have been in the consumer notebooks. This one was not deactivated, and it could allow an attacker to gain privilege escalation again and also modify secure boot settings. The third problem is CVE 2021-3970. This one could give a local attacker privilege escalation and the ability to execute arbitrary code. In all three of these flaws, an attacker could gain persistence, so their attack could survive through a system reboot. UEFI flaws are important because they are harder to detect, and operating system mitigation techniques are generally useless against them because the UEFI sets up boot processes before it hands control over to the operating system for the user. Lenovo recommends users update system firmware versions from the support page manually for their device or by using Lenovo tools to update system drivers from within the operating system. Big shout out to my Hush Puppy Perk level patrons for sharing their fur baby photos and for the support. And a huge thank you to Ash for joining the Alliance on patreon.com/threatwire. I also have a fourth story to cover, which is only available to the Patreon Alliance. So check that out if you are interested over on the Patreon website. Let's go ahead and finish out today's episode with my last top story about zero days. Now, two studies came out last week within days of each other explaining current analysis of zero days being used in attacks. These reports came from Google's Project Zero and Mandiant. Both studies worked together to mold an image of where zero days currently stand in the threat group economy, so I am including both of these in this segment. Mandiant explained in their report, which was posted on the 21st, that zero-day exploitation is on the rise, with them seeing an all-time high of 80 zero days exploited in 2021. Now, previously, the most that they had seen in a one-year time frame was 32 in 2019 and 30 in 2020. They are also seeing more diversity in usage, with more financially motivated attackers using zero days over just state-sponsored espionage-motivated attacker groups. Mandiant noted that Chinese groups continue to exploit the most zero days, and state-sponsored groups are still those primary actors, but the proportion that they are seeing of financially motivated attackers is rising. Now it's about 1 in 3 attacks. Microsoft, Apple, and Google products were the most frequently attacked. No surprise there, since they are all huge companies in the tech sector. Mandiant suspects that this growth is caused by several different factors. There are more zero days available to be used because of a rise in new devices and connected systems to the internet. Exploit brokers are shifting resources towards research and development of zero days. And better defense means detection will also be better, so companies are able to see these types of attacks and those attackers at a greater rate with better visibility. And with that diversification of attackers, that means the scope of attacks is also expanding. So more industries and locales should be increasing their defenses. Discovery of zero days is dynamic as well, so updates to their research could be included in the future. Google's Project Zero also showed 2021 to be a record year for zero days, with them seeing 58 disclosed. Now, that doubled from the previous report of 25 in 2020. Project Zero also attributes this increase to better detection and disclosure, not necessarily just more usage. Project Zero also points out that in most cases, attackers are using old techniques to exploit vulnerabilities, meaning they don't have to put the money into developing and designing new methods if they don't have to. So zero days are not necessarily costly to use or buy for attackers, which could be one of the reasons we are also seeing more financially motivated groups using them. Hey, do you want to see more tech videos from me? Check out my YouTube channel. It's youtube.com/ShannonMorse for everything from tech reviews to security tutorials, like my recent video about malware and tax season scams. Very important information. And with that, do not forget to like and subscribe to Hack5. I'm Shannon Morse, and I'll see you on the internet.